Hi everyone, and welcome back to Egyptology 101. Today we'll be talking about ancient Egyptian canopic jars, which were containers used to hold the mummified organs of a deceased individual. The ancient Egyptians placed great importance on preserving the human body for the afterlife. During the process of mummification, some organs, including the liver, lungs, stomach, and intestines, were removed from the body. These internal organs were dried with natron, coated with resin, and wrapped in linen. Each wrapped organ was then deposited inside a canopic jar, and these jars were placed inside a chest. The canopic equipment sat inside the burial chamber near the body of the deceased. Each of the four internal organs was associated with specific protective deities who are known as the four sons of Horus. The human-headed god Imseti guarded the liver, the baboon-headed god Hapi guarded the lungs, the jackal-headed god Duamutef guarded the stomach, and the falcon-headed god Kebesenuef guarded the intestines. These gods were later placed under the protection of four goddesses, Isis, Nephthys, Neith, and Selket. As we will see, the canopic jars eventually incorporated these protective deities into their design and inscriptions. The earliest examples of canopic containers come from the Old Kingdom. For example, a calcite canopic box with four compartments was discovered in the 4th dynasty tomb of Queen Hetepheres, who was the mother of King Khufu. Although this early example is a box rather than four jars, it shows that the practice of removing, separating, and preserving internal organs was already an important component of Egyptian burials. Individual canopic jars also appear in the Old Kingdom. For example, the 5th dynasty Saqqara tomb of Per-Neb included four limestone canopic jars with simple convex, disc-shaped lids. These jars do not include any inscriptions or decoration on them. Beginning in the First Intermediate Period and continuing on into the Middle Kingdom, canopic jars began to incorporate human-headed lids. Some scholars suggest that these human heads were meant to depict the deceased individual, while other scholars suggest that they depict the four sons of Horus. Here are some examples of Middle Kingdom canopic jars. This first set belonged to a woman named Nephthys, and the jars are made out of limestone and are uninscribed. This second example belonged to a man named Kay, who was an overseer of scribes. His canopic jars are made out of linen covered with stucco. These jars include a single column of inscription, which is an offering formula that mentions Kay's name as well as the four sons of Horus. The third example belonged to a princess named Sidhathor Eunet. Her jars were made out of Egyptian alabaster, and there are traces of blue pigment on the inscription and black and red pigment on the eyes. Her jars include a much longer inscription that invokes the protective gods and goddesses. These three examples all come from the 12th dynasty and include human-headed lids, but they differ greatly in material used, style, and inscriptions. Starting in the 18th dynasty, canopic jars began to have animal-headed lids, which represent the four sons of Horus. For example, the Metropolitan Museum states that the canopic jars of Teti Noct represent the earliest datable examples of animal-headed lids on canopic jars. Three of these canopic jars were found, including the jars depicting Duamutef, Kebesenuef, and Imseti. The jar with the baboon-headed Hapi was missing from the set. Human-headed lids also continue to appear in the New Kingdom, as shown here with these 18th dynasty canopic jars of Ruiu. Her jars are made out of clay, and this particular jar includes a text describing the goddess Neith, who wraps her arms around what is inside the jar and protects Duamutef and the house mistress Ruiu, who is honored before Osiris. Another famous set of human-headed canopic jars was discovered inside the tomb of King Tutankhamun from Dynasty 18. These royal canopic jars were made out of calcite, and the heads depict the king wearing a Nemi's headdress. Each canopic jar held a coffinette in which the wrapped organs of the king were placed. The decoration on the coffinettes included the names of the four sons of Horus. Towards the end of the New Kingdom and into the Third Intermediate Period, a change occurred in the mummification process. The internal organs were removed from the body, wrapped separately, and then they were placed back into the body cavity before the body itself was mummified. Each of these mummified organs was usually accompanied by a small wax or mud figurine representing one of the four sons of Horus, who provided magical protection. Since the organs were placed back into the body of the deceased, canopic jars became superfluous. However, these jars can still be found in tombs in order to ensure the protection of the organs by these gods. Since the jars no longer held the internal organs, some canopic jars from this time period are dummy jars. These jars had removable or non-removable lids, and they either had a very shallow interior cavity or no cavity at all. It is clear that these jars were not meant to hold any organs. By the 25th dynasty, there are examples of canopic jars holding the internal organs once again. These functional jars usually include the zoomorphic heads of the gods, but there are also some human-headed jars as well. As we can see, canopic jars had a long history dating from the Old Kingdom and even into the Ptolemaic period. Although they evolved in style and design, their continued presence in royal and private burials emphasizes their importance and the overall desire to protect and preserve these four organs of the deceased. Thanks for watching today's video. Please check out the description below to find additional resources relating to canopic jars. Also, please feel free to leave any suggestions for topics you would like to see discussed in future videos.